Hello everyone, this is Dr. Tamisha Denis and this is Beauty in the Teeth. Today I'm going to be talking about post-op instructions for after an extraction. So that means whether or not you've had one tooth taken out or maybe all four teeth taken out for wisdom teeth, or maybe you had teeth extracted for braces, whatever reason, an emergency, whatever reason you've had to have a tooth pulled, I'm going to give you some tips and tricks to help you to heal better. Now, one of the very little known facts about extractions and the best way to heal, I'm going to tell you right now. Literally, if you don't watch the rest of the video, this is the most important thing. This is the most important thing. Stay tuned. The number one tip that I give all of my patients after I do an extraction, I always tell my patients, I start to talk to them. Now, mind you, most people have just had a tooth pulled, whatever kind of situation that was, easy extraction, hard extraction. They're numb. They probably didn't want to be there to begin with. And I feel like they blank out a little bit. So what happens is we verbally give instructions, but we also give everything on paper. So what I'm going to do is help you to remember all of those things that usually dentists do. Now, if you want, you can definitely cross-reference everything that I'm saying with your current dentist and make sure in your particular situation that this is correct. But this is generally the same for everyone. Number one tip is do not disturb the area. The reason we say don't disturb the area, your body has all of the capabilities that it needs to put you back together. Yes, you just had a tooth taken out of the area and you have a big gaping hole. Whether or not your dentist stitched you together, typically your hole, the extraction site, is going to heal on its own. That means that if you leave it alone, over time, your body is going to deposit the tissue that is necessary and go through that complicated healing process that you know nothing about, and it's going to put you all back together. Ask anyone who's ever had an extraction. It looks like a big hole. They're kind of obsessed with it. And then if you look in a few months, it's gone. It's gone. Your body is going to be filling that hole. And while your body is doing that process, the number one best thing that you could do is leave it alone. Everyone wants to clean the extraction site, make sure that food doesn't get in there, watch it every day, and that is not what you should be doing. When the body is depositing those things, if you are constantly trying to get food out of it and trying to clean it out all the time, you are not going to allow the body to heal the way that it can naturally do it. And the reason that is because the body is forming a clot. So imagine if you had something ripped off of your skin and a scab started to form. If you are constantly ripping at your scab all the time, how can your body do its job when you're pulling on it all the time? So my number one tip when I tell my patient after they're lying down in the chair, they're bleeding because they just had an extraction, they're numb, they're not really thinking straight, they just want to get out of there, I say, when in doubt, if you forget everything that I say, if you get the paper that I've given you, leave it alone. Leave it alone. If you leave it alone, you're probably better off. Obviously, if you're leaving it alone, time is passing and you're not feeling better, make sure you contact your dentist just to make sure that everything is still on track to feeling better. Yes, it usually takes some time depending on how difficult the extraction was. Difficult extraction, more time for healing. Less difficult extraction, less time for healing. So usually if a tooth pops right out, you're gonna have less pain. And if the tooth takes a lot more for the dentist or if it was really impacted, it's going to take more time for you to feel better. And that is why the dentist typically gives you antibiotic and pain medication to get you through that process. But the number one person that is doing the work is your body, not the medication, not everything else, your body. So if you forget the rest of this video, make sure that you follow those instructions. Now, the rest of what we're going to talk about is really things that you can do just to kind of nurture that process. Number one is follow your dentist's instructions when it comes to medications. When it comes to your antibiotics, take them when the dentist tells you you're supposed to take your antibiotics. And typically pain medication is done as needed. So the dentist will tell you how to take the pain medication. Make sure you're following the instructions on the label and make sure you're not over-medicating yourself. If you're feeling really good, stop taking the pain medication. There's really no need to take pain medication if you're not in pain. A lot of times, if you had a lot of pain before you had the extraction, maybe you had a situation where you were already in pain, just having that situation resolved usually makes you feel better. So watch your symptoms. Typically, I will tell a patient, and this is going to be different for you at home. Typically, I will tell a patient when you, after you take your initial pill of pain pain medication, put a timer on your phone for about 4 hours and see how you feel in 4 hours. Is that pain kind of rolling back in, or are you feeling pretty good? Because if you're feeling pretty good, lay off the pain medication, or maybe you can switch to something over the counter. You must listen to your body and listen to your dentist instructions. Now let's talk about bleeding a little bit. For the most part, it is normal to a certain extent for you to bleed after your extraction. Typically, when a patient leaves the office, what we will tell, we'll give them a piece of gauze to bite down on, and you bite on that gauze for about 30 minutes or so. After you've taken that gauze off in 30 minutes, check the gauze. Are you still bleeding quite a bit, or is it just a little pink with a lot of saliva? If the bleeding has stopped, then you can stop using the gauze. You don't need to walk around with a piece of gauze filled with saliva and no blood if you're not continue to bleed. The concepts that happens in our body is about the same thing in our mouth, meaning putting pressure on the wound will help to stop the bleeding, stop the flow of bleeding. One other tip that we like to give people sometimes is if you feel like you're bleeding a little bit more, maybe you're on blood thinners or some other medication that causes you to bleed more than normal or some other condition, you can take a tea bag, which has tannic acid in it, and you can wet it and just bite down on it and see if it can help to stop that bleeding. Of course, if your bleeding is unreasonable and it's going longer than you think, make sure you contact your dentist and they will help you out, take a look at you and make sure you're okay. Now, pain is, like I said before, the more difficult to extraction, typically the more pain. If that dentist was like, boop, your tooth is out, most likely you're not going to have any pain. But please listen to your body and listen to the dentist. So in terms of pain, I will say on the simple, like I said, you shouldn't have that much pain if you have a simple extraction. However, if you had a very difficult extraction, the dentist took a lot, maybe they had to cut the tooth in multiple pieces, maybe they had to cut your gums, then it may take up to 7 days or longer in some instances for you to feel better. My rule of thumb is if every day you're feeling a little better and a little better and a little better, then most likely you are already on your way to feeling better. Now, if you're feeling worse, or if you're getting a fever, or if it's your pain is intensifying, then that's a little different. You want to make sure that you go back and see your dentist and just make sure everything is okay. Now, swelling is a lot of times related to just the simple act of having something as aggressive as having a tooth pulled. Now, your body, in response to an injury, and having a tooth pulled sometimes feels like an injury to your body, is going to sell cells to the area to help you heal. Those same cells that are going to put that stuff into the socket to help you feel better. Now, something I didn't mention before, which is very important to mention, that when the cells add that, they're going to put this kind of white kind of stuff, which everybody mistakes for something bad. That is the lattice and the cells that are starting to grow over the area to close the extraction site. So do not wipe that away. Leave that there. The reason I said about swelling is because as the cells migrate to the area to come and heal, you might swell a bit. Now, if you're swelling in your mouth a little bit, not so concerning. But if your whole face bows up, then we should be a little bit more concerned. And usually most of the dentists will give you an antibiotic to combat that swelling, or something like an ibuprofen or a medication that will help to kind of bring down that swelling, because the swelling a lot of times causes you pain in addition. It'll push on your nerves and just make your face hurt a little bit more. So the less swelling, typically the less pain. That's sometimes why dentists will postpone your extraction to help your swelling go down with antibiotics before extracting, because that swelling has a lot of things inside. Typically on the front end, bad things, and typically on the back end, better things, healing things. Now let's talk about what you can eat. For the most part, I tell my patients that they can return to their normal diet once they are not numb. The only reason I say that is because when you're numb, you can accidentally bite yourself pretty badly, hurt yourself pretty badly without knowing. Obviously, the dentist just numbed you, so you're not feeling anything. So if you go to eat a sandwich and you're chewing and chewing, you might be chewing on your tongue. You might be chewing on the inside of your lip. You might be chewing on your cheek area, which can be very, very painful once that anesthesia wears off and you realize what you have done. So it's really important that you're careful. So my suggestion typically on the first day of an extraction is to be very gentle with the area. I do recommend people eat, because when you don't eat, what typically happens is you're going to take pain medication and you're you're going to get really nauseous, sometimes even want to throw up, which will make you feel even worse. Throwing up, blood, it's not a good combination. So you want to make sure that you coat your stomach with something soft, maybe a yogurt, maybe a smoothie, not through a straw, maybe a, because we don't want any spitting or sucking through straws, which we're going to get through in a minute. But you want to keep something just to coat your stomach lightly, so that way when you take your pain medication, then you can go ahead and feel a little bit more soothing in your stomach. Now, it is better if you stay away from things that have small little grains like rice and that sort of thing that want to kind of go into your socket. But I would still advise you, if you feel like those things are kind of getting near your socket, that you resist the temptation to pick at it, because now you're going to be breaking rule number one, which is leave it alone. Let's talk about real quick about drinking through a straw. The reason that we ask you not to drink through a straw is because it creates a sucking action, which is going to pull on the socket. So when you're drinking through a straw that way, you're going to be pulling not only to get into your digestive system, but you're also going to be pulling on the extraction site, which is breaking rule number one, to leave the area alone. That brings me to smoking. So the act of smoking, maybe not a popular thing to say, is not very healthy because of the chemicals that are in the smoke for your mouth in general, not just because you just had an extraction, but even more is that pulling action. That drawing action, I'm not a smoker, but the drawing action is also going to be pulling on the socket. So now that we have a pulling action and we have drawing out of the socket, not a good recipe for healing. I tell my patients, please try to resist the urge to smoke after an extraction as long as you can, because you're just giving your body some time to cover up the socket so that at least you're not pulling on the socket as you're smoking. Now, one of the side effects of not listening to that, in particular, the sucking on the straw or the not disturbing the area, and what we're going to talk about in a minute, which is rinsing and smoking, is dry socket. Dry socket is a bad word. Dry socket basically means that the socket is empty. And the socket is empty because you've done all these stuff to remove the healing components that are in that socket that are supposed to heal you. And now we have an empty bone dry socket. And that empty bone dry socket is very, very painful. And I hate to tell you, pain medication is not very good at fixing that bone dry socket. So it is better for you to listen to your dentist's instructions and the instructions that I'm giving you now to avoid these complications, because those complications are harder to fix than simply listening to the instructions. So now we talked about that, we might as well jump into rinsing. Rinsing. No rinsing. I say no rinsing because when you rinse, you're breaking rule number one again. Like I said in the beginning, you listen to rule number one, you probably have all of these things taken care of. So when you're rinsing, especially with something as harsh as a Listerine product or a very alcohol kind of mouthwash, it is very aggressive and not natural to the body. So you're going to be taking away and killing and playing with the bacterial balance inside of your mouth instead of leaving it alone, especially swishing around. So I never know what this word is called, but one of those, not a good idea. Because imagine that drawing action that you're doing and you're pulling on the socket by like that. Now, we do allow you after a few days, if you like, you can use some salt water and just put a little bit of salt water into a glass of water. And when you rinse it, you just kind of let the water kind of go in and out. You're not, you just let the water go in and it just kind of rushes over. A lot of patients like this because it just soothes the area. If there's food in the area, that is the only way that I would recommend trying to take it off. Not picking at it, not digging in it. If there's stitches in it, not pulling them off of the stitches. Maybe just a little light rinse over the area. Now let's talk about eating once more. Once the anesthesia has worn off and you are back to normal, feeling your face again, you can start to begin to eat, but you are going to favor the opposite side, if you have one, to chewing. So if you had all four of your wisdom teeth taken out, that's going to be really difficult. Still try to eat. You need your nutrition. But if you had only one side tooth taken out, you can favor the opposite side, and that opposite side will be much better for you than trying to kind of touch something that is really, really tender. Now let's talk really quick about exercise. Exercise to me falls under the category of three other things. Exercise falls under the category of eating for me, brushing, and exercise. Well, I just said the same thing two times. Exercise falls under the category of also eating and brushing. And the reason that it falls under the category of that is this is definitely the place where you need to listen to your body. If you are exercising and you start to feel as if it is causing a throb in your face, that means you need to lay off. You need to back off. If you're running and all of a sudden it's like, oh man, that really made my face hurt. I always make this story or always tell this story of how when I got one of my implants done, and you can watch a video of me getting my implant done. I went to a cycling class because I love to spin, and I was in the middle of the spinning class because I felt pretty good. I was like, I'm not in any pain, nothing like that. And my face just went do, 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 because I'm increasing the blood flow in my body. So if I start to increase the blood flow in my body, that also means the blood flow to my mouth is going to increase, and I might feel more pain and more discomfort. So it is better. It is better if you listen to your body. I don't say don't exercise at all, but take it easy in the beginning. See how you're feeling. And if you're feeling pretty good, go for it. If you're feeling like it's causing you pain, that means you shouldn't listen. And that means that you should stop or you should slow down. That's why I said the same thing that goes for brushing. I don't advise my patients to stop brushing for long periods of time. However, when you do begin to brush again and you come near that area, you want to be very gentle. Remember, you have a fresh site that has been cut or is bruised or just doesn't feel good, right? So you want to make sure that when you approach the area, then you just go very gently, go very gently. You don't need to brush the extraction site. There's nothing there. So you just need to make sure that you're being gentle. And you'll notice as time goes, when you go to brush again, it doesn't hurt so much. When you go to brush again, it doesn't hurt so much. And if you listen to those things over time, you're going to see how you feel better and better and better. And then you can return to brushing. I find that it's a lot more difficult when you have a tooth extraction in between other teeth. That's a lot harder. But when you have an extraction that is your wisdom tooth, then I find that it's a little easier just to forget about it. You can, because it's all the way in the back and there's no necessity to go all the way back and try to get the toothbrush there. But you want to make sure you brush. You don't want to not brush at all, because the tooth, I find sometimes people, I'll see them after a while and their other tooth is like filled with plaque all the way across the top. We don't want you trying to be immaculate, but you can brush the area gently by listening to your body. Now let's talk about numbness really quick. Everybody's numb when they leave. We kind of want you to be numb for a little while. Why would anyone want to leave having a tooth pulled and feel that pain right away? We need you to have time to get to your pharmacy, to get home, to take that first pain medication before your numbness wears off. So the numbness is going to last for a while. Typically, how long numbness lasts for dental anesthesia is different for everyone. Some people, it's just an hour and it's gone, right? Typically what you'll feel is a tingling sensation, the same kind of tingling sensation that you felt when you were getting numb. And then little by little, that tingling sensation means your nerves are kind of coming back to life. And then you feel it. You feel your mouth again. And that's usually when it's more safe to eat, more safe to do certain things. So you want to listen to your body as that tingling sensation starts to come back. Now there are times where that numbness is permanent or that numbness seems to linger a lot longer than it should. Now, if that's the case, you definitely want to call your dentist and find out what's going on. And that's not something you want to delay. If it's the next day or the day after and you're still numb, you want to make sure you're calling your dentist to find out that everything's okay and see what they can do for you. So those are all my post-op instructions that I give to the patients that come into my office regarding how to care for everything so you can heal the best. If you don't follow these instructions, most likely you're going to have a harder time healing than you really need to. So it's really very important for you to follow these instructions. And I know a lot of times it's really hard. You left the dental office, like I said before, you're bleeding, you don't feel so hot, you know, you just want to get out of there. But you want to remember these things. You want to get some good rest, some good nutrition, take care of yourself so that you heal properly. All right. One last tip that I wanted to give that I didn't give before is ice. Ice is really good to soothe swelling, inflammation. It's really good to kind of just make you feel better in general. I recommend you put some ice on your face after extraction. It just feels nice. It decreases the temperature of the area. And when you put the ice on an area that is numb, make sure that you put it on for a few seconds and take it off periodically, because you don't really know how cold it is and what's it doing to your skin. So make sure you alternate on and off the ice, and it feels great. Okay, so I'm glad you enjoyed this video. And if you like this video, you want to hear more things about how to take care of yourself after a dental appointment, please comment below and I'd be glad to give you more tips and suggestions when it comes to crowns, when it comes to other kinds of procedures that we do in dentistry. All right, this is Dr. Denis and this is Beauty and the Teeth. Bye, see you next time.